This next track is called Stand, and we heard this track on that live with Ed Sullivan. And I've never heard the recorded version, though. We've never checked out the recorded version, so I'm excited to hear this. The one part that I remember is them going, well, yeah, or whatever. It was like, and Mike was doing his dance. It was great.
I don't even remember it at all.
You don't?
No.
It was the first song that came out to, and we were like, whoa, what is this?
I just remember it was called Stand. I don't remember what it sounded like.
You probably remember once we get into it. All right, Stand. Let's stop. Inspiration. Love it. Yeah. Here it is. Ooh, it's slower. This is black empowerment. I love it. That's why they came out to it.
Song.
Yo.
That song is solid.
I love this song.
Yeah. I love both Jermaine and Michael's vocals on this.
Yup. Yet again, you know?
Yeah.
Stand. What an awesome empowerment song.
Yes.
In the end, you'll still be you. I love the way he opens it up with that. In the end, you'll still be you. But this is definitely a black empowerment song. Stand for the things you know are right. All the things you want are real. It's just you to complete, and there's no deal. Dude, I love this, man. This is like, almost like telling white people to stand up for black people, you know? And what's a better way to do that than through a black kid, you know? Mm-hmm. Little boy.
Which a lot of people liked, a lot of white people liked the Jackson 5.
Yeah.
You know, like, a lot.
Yeah.
So I'm sure that changed their mind a little bit, like,
yeah.
You know, they're making all these good, happy message songs, and it's got to make you think, like...
You know, talking about love and stuff.
Yeah, it's got to make you think you're tripping, if you're that way.
And, you know, I feel like it's not until I'll be there... when it really touches them all, you know? Like, this song didn't do well. But, you know, when I'll Be There comes out, that's the one that...
That's everybody my favorite song. That song.
And that's the one that touches them all, mm-hmm. You know?
That song is very... It pulls on your heartstrings very hard.
Now we made it to the last track on the album. It's called Born to Love You. Let's dive. More Mike and Jermaine. Ooh, bar for bar. Sir. Wow, that was good vibes. That was a good vibe.
Yep.
I like, you know, Mike and Jermaine again.
Yep.
Bar for bar, that was great.
Yep.
It was well done. And, you know, it gave Mike enough time by himself to shine at the end and him go off. That was great. Perfect. The trumpets again, just putting you in that bliss state.
It's so sweet to be like, guess I was born to love you.
Right.
You know, the way you said that.
And then the confidence of saying, this is a man with the future in his hands. Don't let go.
Hold on now.
Like,
we speaking, letting you know. We speaking the truth.
They got a future in their hands. And that's facts, though, man. I wonder if that's why this is the last song in the album. Because they're letting you know, like, they got a future. Like, subliminally. You know what I mean?
Right, like, they're just speaking about how they're looking at the future. And with, you know, positive, hopeful eyes. And they're like, I'm gonna have a great future, you know?
Right. Like, think about if this was a message to, like, their new fans, you know? I guess I was born to love you and these new fans. You know, we have a future. You better come on and take my hand. You know? So you could take it a little bit out of context if you wanted to be crazy about it. But, you know, it's mainly just about loving a girl and saying, I was born to love you. And it was love at first sight. Any song with Michael singing about love is just happiness. Like, I just feel nothing but happiness when I listen to it.
Yep. Because you know he's genuine about
yeah.
that, like.
About wanting to spread happiness and be happy.
Yeah. Michael was love.
Yeah.
And music. He was music. He was love. Those words define
yeah.
him and he defines them.
And that's why it's so easy to feel that.
Yeah.
You know.
And also, they were coming out in a time where there was serious racism going on all, you know, everywhere around them, and they just spread love. That, right. You know, that's all they wanted to do was spread love to all races and let them know that, you know, we should all be loving each other. Kindness and love, that's what makes the world go around, you know.
And you can't say that it didn't help, you know? You can't say that the Jackson's music and Michael Jackson and Jackson 5 didn't help bring us together, bring races together. So, our favorite tracks off of this album. So, we already knew I Want You Back and Who's Loving You. And that would be my number one and number two favorite tracks off of this album. Either way, even after learning all of these songs, those would be my number one, number two. But then, after that, Standing in the Shadows of the Love is my favorite that we learned. That's my third favorite track off this album. And I didn't know it was a cover. I thought that it was a new song, but it's actually a cover of the Four Tops song, Standing in the Shadows of Love. So, that's pretty cool. And then after that, I would say that I really enjoyed Stand. I think that's a great track. Just, you know, standing up for yourself and just standing up, just what it meant for the time too, you know, for that message at the time was, you know, strong message. I love that. Zippity Doodah is just bliss. Just pure happiness every time I put that on. And then I really like Can You Remember? I love Michael's soft vocals in that. Sound really sweet. And then after Can You Remember, I like Nobody. And then My Cherie Omar by Jermaine Jackson. I just love Jermaine's vocals in that. But other than that, I'm probably not going to really replay these other tracks, but they're good tracks. But you let me know your favorites down below in the comments. I would really like to know what you guys think of what we thought. You know, our favorites, our top five would be I Want You Back, Who's Loving You, Standing in the Shadows of Love, Stand, Zippity Doodah. But thank you guys so much for watching and critiquing with us. We love every single one of you watching right now. Thank you for chilling with us. If you guys want to, you can click subscribe because we got some more Jackson 5 on the way. We got a whole bunch to learn. We have like 10 albums.
Yeah.
10 Jackson 5 albums to learn, so that's a lot.
Yeah.
And especially with how YouTube wants me to cut up my album reactions, that's a lot of videos. So be on the look for that. That's probably like, I don't know how many songs. Like 50-some songs, at least. If you haven't yet, make sure you guys check out our Michael Jackson playlist we have down below in the description. We have so many Michael Jackson reactions that you guys need to check out. We've already checked out all of the Jackson's albums and a bunch of Michael Jackson stuff, man. It's awesome. So just make sure you check it out. Or I just hope that you've seen that concept because it's amazing. And heard those Jackson's albums because they're amazing. But y'all stay healthy, stay safe. And stay class, Charles, a.k.a. Tyler, a.k.a. Critic. Gone.
Shy. Out.
The name of this tune is the Funky Drummer. The Funky Drummer.